Hello friends, welcome back to our Solution Unlock channel. Today we are diving into the exciting world of Accenture Forage Internship Task 1, where we will unreveal the complexity of data cleaning and data modeling. Now firstly, have an overview on the Accenture Internship Program, that how it works, introduction from Accenture North America, and the task in the program. Moreover, task 1 is project understanding, that is the most crucial steps for data analysts to understand and produce interactive insights. So let's explore more by hitting the next button. This part you can read by your own so that you have more understanding why the program is built, the benefit you gain from this, and what the team see. So move on. Before beginning the task, here they discuss some facts about the program, that you are working as data analyst Accenture and working with a large team with different role positions. Moreover, you are provided a new project for a client named Social Bus. After that, they have shared the key roles and responsibilities of data analyst that sits between the business and the data. Also explaining what is the meaning of this phrase in depth. So go over it once to have good understanding. Now before starting the quiz, read the brief from Social Bus. Understand the project before the call. Let's skip this part and start the quiz. So the first question is, which statement best describes the business problem that Accenture is tasked to address for this project? And the answer is mentioned as, I have done this internship for you guys to help out in the data analytic path. The second is, which statement lists the three requirements for Accenture in task to fulfill for this project? That is, audit of big data practices, recommendation for IPO, and analysis of popular content. Moreover, just follow the steps, and when you hit the next button, there will be another quiz waiting for you. So before starting it, view the model shared below and then jump to the quiz, where they ask which task out of these options is the most relevant to you as a data analyst, and therefore which one will you work on. So the answer is marked. Hit the complete button and hooray, task 1 is done now. Without wasting the time, let's move to the task 2, that is data cleaning and modeling. Now the task overview appears, which describes what you will learn and what you will do. Additionally, a short video. Go and check if you want or press next. Let's dive into the data cleaning phase. Don't worry if you haven't done data analysis before. I will take you through each step and provide support along the way. Here they have given 7 datasets and a data model. However, the steps provided are requirement gathering, data cleaning, and data modeling. So the first step is to use the data model to identify which dataset will be required to answer the business question that is shared, the top 5 categories with the largest popularity. Now after viewing the data model, start the quiz, and according to those 3 datasets should be reaction, content, and reaction type. If you are still confused, read out the quick explanation for your understanding. After this, the data cleaning phase started. The first step will be download all the 3 files simply by clicking on them. Secondly, read the instructions that you need to perform on these data sets. So don't worry, you will be doing all these steps with me. That's very easy, trust me. Removing the rows that have missing values, changing the data type of the column to avoid error, removing columns that are irrelevant to this task. So open the content dataset. Firstly, remove the column that are irrelevant to this task. After that, just rename the header content type instead of type. Now let's select the whole table and click the data in the toolbar and click on filter to remove the rows that have missing values, just to avoid any error. Now see, in the category column there is same name, but due to the quotation marks that appears 2 times, so we need to replace it. Just go to find and replace and type quotation, click find all and then replace all. See, 34 replacements that are now replaced and the data is corrected. Similar working will be done with the reaction table. So let's open it. First thing I noticed is the header type name, replace it by reaction type. Moreover, remove the missing data. Select all missing data and hit the delete button. After the deleting, recheck the blank option again. So yes, see, all missing data is removed. Now delete the URL column, as analysis is especially for content and category. Now similarly goes with the content URL column that I have missed to delete. So now see the datasets are clean and ready for the modeling. From now, the data modeling phase started. Here the first mentioned task is to merge the datasets by using VLOOKUP, and the base dataset should be reaction table. After that, figure out the top 5 performing categories by adding the total scores for each category. Don't get stressed, it's too easy. Just be with me, follow the steps and stay tuned. After completing, you need to drag and drop the Excel spreadsheet containing a cleaned merged dataset and the second, the top 5 performing category. So let's start it. Open the content dataset and add page. After that, cut paste the reaction table for the ease of using VLOOKUP and select the data to enhance readability. And also, don't forget to rename the page to avoid error. Now let's copy paste the headers from the content sheet to the reaction sheet and type the formula, that is equals to VLOOKUP content ID column. Now hit the F4 button to lock the column, but wait, I don't need to lock the cell, I just want the column to freeze, so remove it before the raw number. Now select the content range and type 2 for the column number, and after that type false for exact match. Now see the photo content type appears, just double click right corner triangle to autofill the column with the similar formula, or just drag and drop, both work well. Similar for the category, formula will remain same, but instead of 2 we will type 3. That means we want to take category column against the content ID, and see starting category popped. Just double click to autofill, have a look on the column, all the data is merged nicely as per the requirement. Now the second task is to calculate the sum of scores of each category. For that we need the data from reaction table that have the score column. For this, you need to understand that we are provided scores against the reaction type and need to calculate the scores for category. How can you done that? It's so easy. I have done it and hide it for you guys to try your skill set. Hint is, you need to use VLOOKUP here also to merge the score against the reaction type. And if you figured out the formula, just mention hooray in the comment section below to motivate others. Moving to the last part, select the category column, copy paste it in the next column. Now go to tab, data tab, and hit the remove duplicate icon to have all unique categories. Till now we have figured out all the unique categories in the dataset. Now type the formula, that is equals to sum if category column, score column, and the criteria, that is like animal, soccer and all that, and hit the enter. Hooray, we have calculated the total of the animals category. So just drag and drop the formula to calculate sum of scores for all, rename the columns and filter it by largest to smallest to get the top 5 performing categories. Just highlight them for the clarity. So now we are done with the task 1 and 2, the data cleaning and the data modeling. Share your thoughts, questions or any insights you have gained in the comment section below. Explore more tasks and internship on the Forage platform. Check the link in the description below. Stay curious, keep exploring, and I will